Good morning once again. Welcome to the revision class lecture 7 of DMM 1 subject for second years, second semester mechanical students. So in the lecture 6, we have discussed about the various types of keys and quarters designs. Now in this lecture 7, we'll discuss about the circlips, gaskets and seals. So which are important for the fitting during the assembly of any nuts, bolts, joints or any sleeves. So we require some of the small elements, that is seals, gaskets and circlips. So these are mainly used for preventing the leakage of water, gas, like that, right? So we will discuss these types of circlips, gaskets and seals in this topic. So these are the devices, these are the very small devices, so which we are calling them as circlips, right? So these are mainly placed in between two or three or four mating components, right? These are placed in between the two mating components in order to avoid any leakages. Now see, you will see the introduction of this circlips. First one, what are the circlips? Circlips or retaining rings and snap rings are the fasteners that grasp the elements or installations onto the shaft or in a bore when assembled in a groove. For example, meer cycle repair chesaru ankonde lentha chinna ena component repair chesi open chesi assemble chestunappudu the nut ki bolt ki madhyalo washer untundi. In the same way, similar way, whenever the applications we are using in the shaft and the groove type of things, so we are using this type of circlips. Once it is fixed, the exposed piece functions as a shoulder which holds the particular element or installation. The circlips solves the problem such as clearance diameter, flexible and radial installation, the tolerances, take up and also thrust load capacity. Next one, the circlips, retaining rings and snap rings are now integral components of modern engineering design, right? The services are of very wide range in a wide variety of designs and materials, including the standard phosphate spring steel steels. Right, the materials we are using is stainless steel, prosperous bronze, special plated fitness, like this. Then handy internal and external kits containing various sizes of most popular products are also held in the stock. Right, now we'll see the types of clips and applications of the clips. So where we are using this circlips. So majority of applications that need to turn, spin, pivot where a bearing is used. So ekkadaithe manaki turning, spinning, pivoting action jarugutundo, it may be a bearing or a joystick or some part of applications in the elements in the any machine members, like electric motors we are using, the turbines we are using, the pistons we are using, the vehicle construction. So we are using not very few quantity, over 10 or 15. So we are using thousands and hundreds of circlips, depends upon the construction. Next, brake adjustment we are using, optical devices, sprocket chains, electronics, wheel bearings, gearing transmission, and clutches. So these are the applications where we are using these things. Next, what are the basic types of circlips? The external circlip standard. See here, the red color portion is a circlip. So this is a code of this circlip, the most common form of axial retail for shafts with the grooves. Generally, only metric sizes are manufactured for 3mm to 300mm. So the specifications are heavy duty versions, various configurations also available on the request. Next one is external circlip lugged type. So idi chudandi standard type undi, ikkadku vachesi manaki koncham ikkada protrude ayyindi anamata. This is external circlip lugged type. These are fitted to the shaft with the grooves. Okay, and this feature assists in maintaining good contact with the chamfered components for 16mm to 140mm. Next, third one is internal circlips. These are also generally used for the manufacturing of 8mm, 36, 360mm diameter bores, and these are also used for heavy duty versions, and these are used for the axial retainer for bores with the grooves. Next, internal circlips. So external ku vachesi meeku bayataku anistuntundi, internal vachesi bore lopala untundannamata. This is a shaft, this is a internal, these are fixed. These are also internal circlip lugged type of thing. Then these are also axially fitted to the bores, the grooves, right? And these are also assisting maintaining good contact with the chamfered components as shown in the figure. Next type is E-type circlips. So the E-type circlips is, these are placed in this position in the shaft. So these are all the most common radially fitted circlips with the two shafts with the grooves. The normal size is so and so, and these are also used for installation of these things. Next, snap rings. Actually, axially fitted in shallow grooves as conventional circlips, often used for narrow section components with a lightweight loads. Unlike circlips, special fitting tools are often required in this case. The snap rings are generally inserted externally as well as internally, right? See here, this is internal setup, this is the external setup. So these are the types of circlips where we are using, right? See here, these are of very small thickness and very excise. Next concept is mechanical seal. Mechanical seals. Then what is the purpose of a seal? The purpose of a seal is to prevent or limit flow between the components. The purpose of seal is to prevent or limit flow between the components. Seals are the important aspect of machine design, where pressurized fluids must be contained within an area of machine, such as hydraulic container, contaminants, or lubricants retained, right? So see this one. These are some of the seals we are using for this shaft assemblies. See the seals, the different diameters and different thickness and different materials. So these are the seals where you are placing in between the shaft and the coupling shaft and the hub or the shaft and the boss, right? Next, coming to the types of seals, we are having two types of seals. One is static seals, another one is a dynamic seals. These are falling into two categories. The static seals, where sealing takes place between the two surfaces that do not move relative to each other. So by the name says the static. And a seal is placed in between the two surfaces which does not move together to each other. And coming to the dynamic seals, where sealing takes place between the two surfaces that moves relative to each other, by the example, rotary or reciprocating motion. So dynamic seals means these are the seals which are placed in between the two surfaces and these are moved either rotary or reciprocating. Next, leakage. See here, this is a boundary, this is a boundary, this is a liquid, this is a fluid. A clearance between two components will permit the passage of fluid molecules in each direction. A direction depending on the pressure and momentum associated with the fluid. Here also, if you see, this is one type of fluid, this is other type of fluid. So whenever we have to keep any clearance in between the two types of fluids, we can keep a type of seal which can prevent the moving of this fluid into this fluid. Next, coming to the seals classification. So we are having various types of seals. First one is static seals, as we said. Second one is a dynamic seals. In the static seals, we are having gaskets, sealants. In the dynamic seals, we are having rotating shaft seals and reciprocating shaft seals. So gaskets, sealants. For example, if you see a sealant, for example, in a pressure cooker of your house, మీరు ప్రెషర్ కుక్కర్ రైస్ పెట్టేటప్పుడు ఏం చేస్తారు? సో ప్రెషర్ కుక్కర్కి ఆ పైన లిడ్కి కింద బేసిన్ కింద బేసిన్కి మధ్యలో లిడ్ లోపల మీకు ఒక గ్యాస్కెట్ ఉంటుంది అనమాట, రైట్? సో దిస్ ఈస్ యాక్టింగ్ యాజ్ ఎ సీల్ సో దట్ ఇట్ డస్ నాట్ ఎస్కేప్ ద వాటర్ వేపర్ అవుట్ సైడ్, రైట్? గ్యాస్కెట్. నెక్స్ట్ కమింగ్ టు ద డైనమిక్ సీల్స్, మనము ఎందుకంటే షాఫ్ట్స్ నకిల్ డిఫరెంట్ టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ షాఫ్ట్స్ అండ్ జాయింట్స్ గురించి మాట్లాడుకుంటున్నాం కాబట్టి వీ ఆర్ డిస్కసింగ్ ఓన్లీ అబౌట్ డైనమిక్ సీల్స్. నౌ కమింగ్ టు ద రోటరీ రొటేటింగ్ షాఫ్ట్ సీల్స్, వీఆర్ హ్యావింగ్ ఫేస్ సీల్స్ అండ్ ఇంటర్స్టిషియల్ సీల్స్, రైట్? రొటేటింగ్లో ఫేస్ అండ్ ఇంటర్స్టిషియల్. ఇన్ దిస్ ఫేస్ సీల్స్ యూఆర్ హ్యావింగ్ యాక్సియల్ సీల్స్ అండ్ రేడియల్ సీల్స్. Under the axial seals, you are having mechanical seals. Under radial seals, you are having lip ring seals, packings, fleet seals, circumfill seals. Next, interstitial seals lo manaki bush seals unnai, labyrinth seals unnai, rim seals unnai, and you are having brush seals unnai, ferrofluidic seals unnai, right? So these are the differences in rotating shaft seals. Coming to the reciprocating shaft seals, they are used for packings and piston rings. So this is the entire classification of seals. Next, coming to the selection of the seals. Okay, selection of the seals. Some of the considerations in selecting the type of seal include the nature of the fluid to be contained. Next, the pressure levels either side of the seal. Next, the nature of any relative motion between the seal and mating components. Next one, the level of sealing required. Next one, the operating temperatures. Next one, the life expectancy and the serviceability. Next one is total cost. So these are the considerations of selecting the seals. So like this, we will discuss how we have the information about the mechanical seals. So till now we have discussed about the circlips and the mechanical seals. Next, coming to the gaskets. So these are also the tiny objects, or some cases the bigger diameter objects, depends upon the shaft diameter, and these are also having less thicker than the main assembled parts, right? So these are the various materials, these are the various shapes of the gaskets, starting from ring size to the different intricate shapes, right? But coming to the washer is different from gasket, right? Next, compatibility. Every sealant must be compatible with the fluid it is sealing. So it depends upon the medium what the pipe is having. So pipe lo manaki liquid, what type of liquid? Like it is a highly viscous liquid, low viscous liquid. Depends upon those things also, we have to keep in consideration the design compatibility, the compatibility of the sealants. If not, the seal will break down. What happens if properly we are not matching the compatibility with the fluids? What happens? The seal will get breakdown, either chemically or physically. Then the joint will become leak. That's why we are using the sealants or gaskets. Next, coming to the types of gaskets. We are having various types of gaskets, that is ring gasket, full face gasket, spiral wound gasket, jacketed gasket, envelope gasket, split ring gasket, strip gasket, ring type joint, and a graphite impregnated, right? So we will see the each of them with the figures. So what is a ring gasket? Ring gasket or flat usually do not donut shape on them. Meeru bakery lo velthe donuts dorukutai, just like a donut we are having the shape of the ring gasket. These are used for the pipe flanges. See the white color portion, these are placed in this gap, right? Then the fits inside the flange bolt circle, the normally withstands up to 200 pressures. So next one is full face gasket. ఎప్పుడన్నా ఒక ఆటోమొబైల్ షాప్స్కి వెళ్ళి ఇఫ్ యూ ఆస్క్ గ్యాస్కెట్, యూ కెన్ సీ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ వేరియంట్స్ ఆఫ్ గ్యాస్కెట్స్ డిపెండ్స్ అపాన్ ద డయామీటర్, ద కలర్ అండ్ ద సైజ్ థిక్నెస్. సో దిస్ ఈస్ అ ఫుల్ గ్యాస్కెట్. సో గ్యాస్కెట్ కూడా జస్ట్ డయామీటర్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ పైప్ లాగా ఉంటుంది. వీఆర్ హ్యావింగ్ ఇంటర్స్టిషియల్. దెన్ ద ఫ్లాట్ యూజువల్లీ డోనట్ షేప్డ్, కవర్స్ ద ఎంటైర్ ఫ్లాంజ్ ఫేస్. సో ఇక్కడ ఒక రకంగా ఉంది, ఇక్కడ ఓన్లీ ఈ బుష్ వర్కే, ఇంతవరకే హబ్ వర్కే ఉంది, నాట్ ద ఫుల్ థింగ్. But here if you see, it is completely filled the space, covers entire flange face. It has bolt holes to match the flange. So manaki ela undi, so in order to match these two flanges, deeniki already holes unnai kabatti, it is also designed in the form of this concept. Next, third one is spiral wound gasket. See here, this is of the spiral wound color shapes gaskets. cavities are flat, usually donut shaped, normally made up of stainless steel with a graphite insert. So idantha stainless steel anukunte lopalo chesi graphite insert untundannamata. Next, these are crushable with a high resistance. Resistance means the ability to expand and contract with the changes in the pressure, temperature and pipe movement. Em cheptunna ka resistance ante enti? Crushable means depends upon the external forces like pressure, temperature and the movement of the pipe, the gaskets will get crushable. Next one is jacketed gasket. Just manaki ila ganistundi. These are metal exterior, normally stainless steel material. Internal filler material is older filler, was mainly asbestos. Removal only if you are certified. Jacket prevents filler material from contaminating the system fluid. Next, fifth one is envelope gasket. Next, fifth one is a envelope gasket. Here in this envelope gasket is a Teflon exterior material, and internal is filler material. Some basic principles as a jacketed in the gasket, but as a limited temperature range. So it depends upon this envelope type of material, because it is a Teflon material means it is a some sort of plastic material. Therefore, we are having some limitations, depends upon the temperature range. Next one is superior sealing capacity, mainly on imperfect flange fit-ups. Okay. Next, coming to the split ring gasket. These are a donut shape with many different configurations, and these are of two half ring pieces. Split ring and enti oka ring ila untundi, right? Oka ring ila untundi, other ring will be same, just your this shape. This is a half ring. Next, to fit into joint where flange or pipes can't be separated. Next, see here, these are the split rings. See here, in that manner, figure vesamu. So just manaki fit cheskuntunnamanta. These are fitted like this and we are fastened. See, this is a assembled piece of a split ring. Idoka ring. These are fitted with this stud and the nut. See here how it is placed, the application, the practical application. Idoka pipe. This pipe ikkada chudandi, pipe ending ikkada undi. So ee rendu ela fit chestamu, it is having the diameter of the same thing, and these are fitted in this direction, right? Next, strip gasket ante just manaki sellotape laga manaki ekkada gaunte akkada, depends upon our applications, depend upon our space, manaki etla gaunte atla we can attach this type of gasket. A long strip of flat round material, oka strip laga untundannamata coil lo, just manaki bandage laga, right? Purchased as a bulk wound on a roll, it is cut to length, manaki ekkada gaunte akkada length varaku cut chesukoni we can go for a joint. Usually Teflon or mixed with the Teflon. So what is the material? So we are using Teflon material, direct Teflon material or mixer of Teflon material. Next, these are used for medium pressure and low pressure. Next one, these are used for temporary repairs. For example, if you see any carpentry work chestunnappudu oka chakka veneer, they take some sort of newid or plywood, dan meeda teflon sheet vesi fevicol tho atikistaru. Once fevicol tho atikichin tarvata దాని మీద కొంచెం వెయిట్ పెట్టిన తర్వాత ఇంకా మనం ఏం చేస్తారు, అడిషనల్ సపోర్ట్గా టెకలోమ్ షీట్ పైకి రాకుండా ఏం చేస్తారంటే, దే విల్ టేక్ ఏ స్మాల్ వైట్ టేప్స్ అండ్ దే విల్ అటాచ్ అరౌండ్ ద ఎడ్జెస్ ఆఫ్ ద షీట్. దట్ ఇస్ ఎ టెంపరీ. ఇది కూడా అంతే, వెన్ ఎవర్ డ్యూరింగ్ ద అసెంబ్లింగ్ ఆర్ ఎనీ రిపేర్ వర్క్స్, ముందు ఇది వేసేసి వర్క్ చేసేసి తర్వాత దీన్ని తీసేసి పర్మనెంట్ గ్యాస్కెట్, నాట్ పర్మనెంట్ గ్యాస్కెట్, a good quality when compared to this removal type, they will keep other type of gaskets what we have described in the earlier slides, and not for permanent installations. Okay, these are not for permanent installations, only temporary ga we are using this type of things. Next one is ring type joint gasket. Next one is a ring type joint gasket. Here these are flat, usually donut shape. See here, these are flat, usually ownership of things. Next, usually metal type, used with flanges that have concentric grooves. Just manaki ring laga manaki finger ki veskune ring laga it is in this form. Next, gaskets is compressed into the grooves. Used at high pressure applications, that is 2000 psi or higher. It has been used for 50,000 psi applications. Next, ninth one is graphite impregnated gasket. Graphite impregnated gasket. These are also donut shaped and fiberglass impregnated with the particles of graphite. So they're making along the so fiberglass to tayar chestunnaru and the particles of graphite. Next one is usually used mainly in high temperature applications where you are used because of this fiberglass and graphite material. This can be used for the elevated temperature applications. Then the graphite makes them reactive to oxygen. Then what is the limitation here? The limitation is the graphite material kabatti oxidation jaragadaniki ekkuva chances undi. Next, what are the gasket materials? Next one is gasket material. So the various gasket materials are according to the type and according to application. We are having natural rubber material, EDPM material, Nipron material, nitrile material, silicon material, Viton material, Amerlon material, graphite and soft metal, right? So these are the various types of materials where we are using these materials for the manufacturing of the gaskets. Depends upon the application, we have to choose the material. Now, if you see one of the materials like a soft metal, so soft metal and ante generally this type of copper, aluminium, right, brass like this. So usually annealed copper or aluminium is used for this. The metal chosen for non-reactivity to the environment and the environment ki reaction jaragakunda undadaniki we are using non-reactivity type of material for this gasket manufacturing. Then it is having a high wear resistance and also having high pressure resistance and usually heavy in oil and gas pipelines. So I could use some applications. So this soft metal type of applications are generally used in oil and gas pipelines. Next, usually heavy in high pressure industrial applications. High pressure industrial applications. Next, coming to the color and coats. So color and coats are very important concept during this manufacturing of the gasket and applications of the gaskets. Most of the manufacturers color code their gaskets. Next, the color codes can represent different types, materials or sizes. So color codes endu kistunnaru. So during the manufacturing or inventory or in the stores or in the application, so they take the color. These are represented different types of gaskets. So color representation use of the material chip code and use of the, and also sizes, right? Next, all the manufacturers have different color coding schemes. So depends upon the manufacturing concern and the geographical area, the manufacturers have their different mixed color codings or single color coding. So that's why if you see the gaskets, మనకి మెటల్ కాపర్ వచ్చేసి ఆ కలర్ లో ఉంది. సీ హియర్ దిస్ అ కాపర్ మెటీరియల్, దిస్ అ అల్యూమినియం మెటీరియల్. సో అదర్స్ చూడండి, సీ అదర్ మెటీరియల్ బ్లాక్, బ్లాక్ గా ఉందంటే కార్బన్, దట్ ఈస్ అ గ్రాఫైట్. సీ హియర్ దిస్ ఆర్ ఆఫ్ స్టీల్ టైప్, దిస్ ఆర్ ఆఫ్ అ స్ట్రిప్, అంటే ఇది ప్లాస్టిక్ మెటీరియల్ కాబట్టి సమ్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ కలర్ మెటీరియల్. సో దిస్ ఆర్ ఆల్సో ద మెటల్ టైప్, రైట్? సో సీ హియర్ దిస్ ఆర్ లామినేటెడ్ ఎన్వలప్ టైప్ ప్లాస్టిక్. It's also jacketed stainless steel material. If you chudandi colors unnai din meeda, right? So this is also one type of paper sheet, thick paper sheet. So like this, you are having the colors on this on the manufacturing during the manufacturing of the gasket. Understood? So these are the main important things which are added additionally during the assembly of shafts, couplings like that. Next coming to the joints. Next coming to the design of joints. What are the various design of joints? If you see the notations of the various types of joints here, we are having various types of joints. So in the first case, the design of sprocket, design of socket, and design of socket and spigot quarter joint. Design of socket and spigot quarter joint. So if you see the design of socket and the spigot quarter joint, here the P is load carried by the rods. And if notations, E notations, we have to maintain everywhere. P is equal to load carried by the loads, D is equal to diameter of the rod, T1 is equal to outer diameter of the socket, D2 is equal to diameter of the spigot or inside diameter of the socket, D3 is equal to outside diameter of the spigot collar, T1 is equal to thickness of the spigot collar, D4 is equal to diameter of the socket collar, C is equal to thickness of the socket collar, M is equal to mean width of the quarter, T is equal to thickness of the quarter, L is equal to length of the quarter, A is equal to distance from the end of the slot to the end of the rod, sigma 1 is equal to permissible tensile stress, tau is equal to permissible shear stress, sigma C is equal to permissible crushing stress. These are the notations of socket and spigot quarter joint. Next coming to the student, heading pettanu meer ok sar check chesukondi, right? So a book lo aina kuda koncham edana marana kuda, but the notations are like this one. Next coming to the design of jib and quarter. P is equal to maximum thrust or pull in the connecting rod. T is equal to diameter of the adjacent rod. P1 is equal to width of the strap. P is equal to total width of the jib and quarter. Small t is equal to thickness of the quarter. T1 is equal to thickness of the strap. Sigma t is equal to permissible tensile stress for the material of the strap. 11. Tau is equal to permissible shear stress for the material of the quarter and the gib. Right? Next one is design of gib and quarter for square rods. ఇక్కడికి వచ్చేసి ఏం జరిగింది? డిజైన్ అండ్ గిబ్ ఆఫ్ ఎ క్వార్టర్ జాయింట్ ఫర్ స్ట్రాప్ ఎండ్. ఇక్కడ వచ్చేసి మనకి స్క్వైర్ రాడ్. హియర్ నౌ ఇఫ్ యు సీ P is equal to load carried by the rods. X is equal to each side of the rod. Capital B is equal to total width of the gib quarter. B1 is equal to width of the strap. T is equal to thickness of the quarter. T1 is equal to thickness of the strap. Sigma T, tau, and sigma C are permissible tensile stresses on this one. Next, coming to the design of sleeve and quarter joint. Design of sleeve and quarter joint. This one. Design of sleeve and quarter joint. Here, P is equal to load carried by the rods, D is equal to diameter of the rods, D1 is equal to outer diameter of the sleeve, D2 is equal to diameter of the enlarged end of the rod, T is equal to thickness of the quarter, L is equal to length of the quarter, B is equal to width of the quarter, A is equal to distance of the rod end, C is equal to distance of the rod end from its end to the quarter hole. These are the permissible tensile, shear, and crushing stresses respectively for the material of the rods and quarter. Next. Design of quarter joint to connect the piston rod and the cross head. Now what is the D here? D is equals to diameter of the parallel part of the piston rod. D1 is equals to diameter of the tapered end of the piston. D2 is equal to diameter of the piston rod at the quarter. T3 is equals to diameter of the socket through the quarter hole. B is equals to width of the quarter at the center. T is equals to thickness of the quarter. And these are permissible stresses in tension, shear, and crushing stresses. D is equals to diameter of the piston. P is equals to effective steam pressure of the piston. Next, coming to the design of a quarter foundation bolt. So D1 is the diameter of the bolt. D1 is equal to diameter of the enlarged end of the bolt. T is equal to thickness of the quarter. P is equals to width of the quarter. V is equal to width of the quarter. Next. What are the methods of failure of a knuckle joint? The notations are P is equals to tensile load acting on the rod, D is equal to diameter of the rod, D1 is equal to diameter of the pin, D2 is equal to outer diameter of the eye, T is equal to thickness of the eye, and T1 is equal to thickness of the fork. Now, the sigma T, tau, and sigma C are permissible stresses for the joint material in tension, shear, and crushing. Now, see the design procedure of a knuckle joint. T is equal to diameter of the rod, sigma T is equal to permissible tension stress. So, design of a turnbuckle is not silver so ledu. Next. Now, we'll see what is a quarter joint, what are the various types of quarter joint, and what are the topics to be covered according to your syllabus. So coming to the various types of quarter joints, we are having socket and spigot quarter joint, sleeve and quarter joint, gib and quarter joint, right? So if you see the socket and spigot quarter joint, so ee figure meer already ekkada vesaru machine drawing subject lopala we have drawn this figure, right? So this is one portion, this is one material, this is one component, this is other component, this is other component. So if you get a question or if you get a neatly sketch and explain socket and spigot quarter joint annapudu you have to draw this figure and you have to explain this figure. So in notations as it is undali. Now see here the first one, socket collar, this is a quarter, this is a clearance, this is a socket material. Now see that this is the diameter of the shaft. The pressure is in this direction. So where is D1? So this is a D. This is a D1. This is a D2. This is a D3. And this is a D4. So whenever you are drawing the figure, don't mix up the figures. First, separate it away. And after that, see here, the pink colored portion is one material. The pink colored portion is one component. దీని లోపల గ్రూవ్ ఉంది కాబట్టి దీని లోపల ఈ షాఫ్ట్ ఇన్సర్ట్ అయింది. సో ఆఫ్టర్ ద షాఫ్ట్ షాఫ్ట్ ఇస్ ఇన్సర్టెడ్ ద క్వార్టర్ ఇస్ ఇన్సర్టెడ్ వెర్టికల్లీ, రైట్? సో దిస్ ఇస్ ద ఫిగర్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ సాకెట్ అండ్ స్పైగట్ క్వార్టర్. సో సాకెట్ ఏది? దిస్ వన్ ఇస్ అ సాకెట్. ద పింక్ కలర్ పోర్షన్ ఇస్ సాకెట్ అండ్ స్పైగట్ ఏది? స్పైగట్ ఇస్ అ బ్లూ కలర్ పోర్షన్. ఈ లోపల ఏంది కదా, దిస్ ఇస్ అ స్పైగట్ అండ్ వాట్స్ అ క్వార్టర్? దిస్ వన్ ఇస్ అ క్వార్టర్. గాట్ ఇట్? సో దిస్ ఇస్ అ side view of this quarter. So ee side view lo em chupistunnam manamu, thickness of the quarter chupistunnamu, length of the quarter. Now in a socket and spigot quarter joint, one end of the rods is provided with a socket type of the end is shown in the figure, and the other end of the rod, say B, is inserted into the socket. Ee socket lopala spigot anedi insert chestunnamu. The end of the rod which goes into the socket is also called as spigot. Adhamaindi kada, is also known as spigot. So ee rod ki ee lopala insert chestunnam em cheptunnam, spigot an antunnam. Now a rectangular hole is made in the spigot and socket. A quarter is then driven tightly through the hole in order to make the temporary connection between the two rods. The load is usually acting axially, but it changes its direction, hence the quarter joint must be designed to carry the both. So because of this load is acting axially, so load manaki ela act chestundi, axially act chestundi kabatti the joint must be designed to carry both tensile load as well as the compressive loads. The compressive load is taken up by the quarter the spigot. So if you get any question, sketch and explain socket and spigot quarter joint annapudu ee figure veyandi, scale tho avasaram ledu. రఫ్గా నీట్గా వేయండి అండ్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ దిస్ ఫిగర్. ఎక్స్ప్లెనేషన్ అంటే ఏంటి? ఇది ఒక కాంపోనెంట్ వన్ అనుకోండి, దీని పేరు ఏమంటున్నాము? దిస్ ఇస్ అ సాకెట్, దీని స్పైగట్ అంటున్నాము. సో ఫస్ట్ ఫిగర్ వేసిన తర్వాత, సో జస్ట్ మీరు ఓన్ వర్డ్స్లోనే రాయచ్చు, రైట్? సో ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ లెఫ్ట్ హ్యాండ్ సైడ్ So a socket is taken, and from the right hand side, a spigot is taken, and it is inserted into the whole axillary of the sanjipesi. Atamiru, by seeing the figure also, you can write the matter. Next. Next, coming to the design of socket and spigot quarter joint. Design of socket and spigot joint. So we'll stop the class here. I think the time is up. So we'll continue the class in the next session.